I haven't lost interest, but my ability to care has been fairly limited, mostly due to long-term mental health issues. These words were written by Lassie Collins, an unpaid open source maintainer of a vital library that major corporations rely on to run their billion-dollar businesses. These words reveal a crisis that's brewing in the free software world, which has impacted three of my favorite projects and possibly some of yours too. Open source software is the backbone of our digital world. It's freely available for anyone to use, to modify, and to share. It powers everything from Android smartphones to most websites. But there's trouble brewing. The people behind these projects are burning out, they're struggling to make ends meet, and watching their passion projects become corporate pawns. This XKCD cartoon sums it up very nicely. And so we'll explore three eye-opening examples: a popular database, a crucial library, and an educational platform. Each story reveals a different facet of the open source crisis. Are you ready to peek behind the curtain? The story of the LibLZMA vulnerability reveals the darker side of open source development that affects us all. Lassie Collins maintained the XZ library. You've probably heard neither of him nor of his library. After all, it doesn't do anything exciting. It implements an effective compression algorithm. But when you use a terminal to connect to a remote server, that uses a tool called SSH. And as you might have guessed, SSH uses XZ. However, a chain is only as strong as its weakest link, and this is where the XKCD strip comes back to bite us. In this case, the weakest link was XZ, or more precisely, Lassie Collins, the sole unpaid maintainer. And so he came under attack, a two-pronged good cop, bad cop attack. On the one hand, comments started pouring in from users, slowly turning the screw. They clamored for new features and quick fixes. They claimed to be frustrated by the maintainer's work rate. One user insisted that the community desires more. As the pressure grew, the maintainer was less and less able to face all the demands. Thankfully, another developer, Jia Tan, stepped up to the plate and started shouldering the heavy responsibility of maintaining the project. Jia Tan took on the co-maintainer role with the right to approve pull requests. Except that, in a cruel twist, this so-called helper was the good cop prong of the attack, a wolf in sheep's clothing. Once they gained control, they slowly started changing the code. They changed settings to remove security checks and then injected a sophisticated backdoor into the library. This would, in essence, allow them to take over Red Hat and Debian distributions. Again, we come back to the XKCD strip. Big companies rely heavily on open source projects, which rely heavily on individual maintainers. When these key people falter, the entire system becomes vulnerable. But it's not just security attacks. I've often seen maintainers' work taken for granted in GitHub issues. We complain when features don't work exactly as we expect, or when we don't understand the documentation. The emotional toll on maintainers can't be overstated. Constant demands, little to no recognition, and the weight of responsibility can crush even the most passionate developers. It's a recipe for burnout that directly impacts the security and stability of the software that we use daily. It's not all gloom and doom. We have the power to make a difference. Simple acts of kindness and encouragement can go a long way. Using positive language in bug reports, expressing gratitude for fixes and enthusiasm for the work that's being done, acknowledging the hard work of maintainers can help create a more supportive environment. Now, while supporting open source maintainers is crucial, what happens when a project outgoes its humble beginnings? Let's talk about Redis. Redis started as a labor of love by Salvador Antires Sanfilippo in 2009. It was a classic open source story, one developer with a vision creating something valuable for the community. I've mentioned it elsewhere, it's a technology that I love. But as Redis grew in popularity, it caught the eye of bigger players. In 2014, Garantia Data rebranded itself as Redis Labs and became the official sponsor of the Redis project. On surface, this might seem like a win-win: more resources, more support. What could possibly go wrong? Well, as it turns out, quite a bit. As time went on, Redis Labs, now simply called Redis, began to blur the lines between the company and the project. They started to claim credit for Redis's inception, effectively erasing Sanfilippo's role in creating the project. Their website claims get the world's fastest database from those who built it. And yet, despite Redis, the company, taking center stage, most of the core contributions and innovations still came from the open source community. Until Redis, the company, decided to change the license from a fully open source model to a more restrictive one. It's a strange situation where the company benefits from the visibility and branding while the community does much of the heavy lifting. Now, this raises big questions about the relationship between open source projects and corporate sponsors. Can they coexist without compromising the project's integrity? Is corporate involvement necessary for widespread adoption? And more importantly, how do we ensure that the original vision and the community spirit of these projects don't get lost in the shuffle? However, while some open source projects grapple with corporate influence, others face a different challenge entirely. What happens when a free platform becomes too successful for its own good? Exorcism, a coding education platform that I'm a big fan of, recently celebrated a massive milestone, 2 million users and 45 million exercise submissions. On the surface, these numbers paint a picture of resounding success. But dig a little deeper and things get darker. Despite its impressive user base, Exorcism is facing significant financial hurdles. In a recent blog post, the team announced that they had to lay off one of the core team members. The article stated that keeping something free for everyone relies on either the user being the product or on significant donations. How can you balance accessibility with financial stability? Now, Exorcism has been exploring various adaptations like streamlining operations to reduce the burden on volunteers, but technical adjustments alone might not be enough. So Exorcism is also considering for-profit operations to sustain itself. Now, in light of these challenges, the founder made a sobering admission. He said, "I think it's fair to say that at this stage, I've lost faith in the non-profit business model working in any way that allows Exorcism to reach any of its potential." Open source projects face a trifecta of challenges: burnout, financial instability, and corporate pressures. I've highlighted three examples, but there are more, like the Contentful Library that I mentioned in a previous video and that I still like to use, even though it's no longer really maintained. But there's hope, I think. What can we do? Well, first, you might want to consider financially supporting your favorite project. Even small donations can make a big difference. If money's tight, if you have other things to do with your money, you could contribute your time and your skills by helping with bug fixes or feature development. And if you don't feel comfortable contributing code, engaging positively with maintainers can help them feel less taken for granted. And of course, you don't need to code to help with the documentation. Open source software isn't just free stuff that we consume. It's a community that we all belong to. You're not just a user, you're a potential contributor. Whether through code or cash or community support, you can be a part of the solution. Thank you for listening to me. I'll see you in the next video.